Well, this was a song that got started back in 2008. We were traveling with our very unusual Christmas band, the Bittersweet Christmas Band, and we were doing a concert in Viroqua, Wisconsin on the third Saturday in December. And there were 40-mile-an-hour winds and a blizzard, and, well, there's four people in the band, and the audience outnumbered us, by golly.
Two extra people had a great time. So we came to your house the next day to do an afternoon concert.
Yeah.
We made it.
Yeah. And the people we stayed with are a mixed-race couple, and it was right after the election, and, of course, everybody was talking about, you know, Obama and his mixed race heritage, and finally the man just piped up and said, you know, I think the answer to all this racism and hatred is people just need to marry each other and have mixed race kids because you can't hate your own kids.
Well, yes, you can.
Not for that reason. Not for that reason. So a few weeks later, we had to do a UU service on the Sunday before both Martin Luther King Day and Barack's inauguration on Tuesday. And this song sort of popped out for that, kind of prompted by that conversation. And people have said, Susan, is that your story? And the answer is no, I have not been the mother of physical children in this life. But it was the story of many women in the late 1960s when we tend to forget, with all our wonderful technology, which we love as much as anybody else, that in those days, someone could be passing through, and they didn't tell you their real name, even if they did, you know, and they moved on. You couldn't find them, you know, unless they wanted to be found.
So just like the child ballads.
Yeah. So this is called Child of the Future, and it has a surprise ending, which I was, again, not expecting when I started writing this, because things take charge.
Say, this is not a political song, it is a story
song. It is a story song, yeah. I met your handsome granddad at a march against the war. Chicago, 1968, Grand Park. His hair was grown out natural, his skin was smooth and brown. Eyes set brown with lashes long and dark. And maybe you could say we fell in love there at first sight. Or maybe it was something else we shared. But either way, we spent 3 days together, noon to night. His dusky skin against my own so fair. Skin so smooth and velvet brown, and my green eyes and auburn hair in curls. And neither black nor white kids would accept her as their own, a sad and very lonely little girl. But we adopted mongrel cats and puppies from the pound. Go and see the hybrids at the zoo. She saw that they were stronger than the purebred ones by far. And I would say, you see, they're just like you. In college, there were many mixed race students like your mom. At last, she could be happy. side by side to make a dream into reality. And when a man with skin of brown became our president, he cried and cheered and sang along with me. And in Grant Park, that warm November night, I found a man who'd been my lover 40 years before. All the bitter words I could have said just fell away, no room for them in my heart anymore. He told me of his family, they lived out in L.A. He wept so hard in hearing of my own. But when the man who changed the world that day got up to speak, we dried our tears and vowed to carry on.